Hi, and welcome to Homeschooling 101, Basics for Parents Before You Start. In this video, we are going to tackle legal readiness and then also teacher readiness. I want to send you to a really extensive post with everything you need to know when you're first starting out homeschooling. You can find it at 401more.com/new. All right, let's jump into today's topic. First of all, legal readiness. It's a really short topic. That's why I stuck it in this video as well. Basically, you need to know the laws for your state and where to find excellent legal advice. And the best place I know of is if you go to hslda.org. This is Homeschool Legal Defense Association. They will give you a map where you can click on your state and you can find all the details regarding the requirements of your state. You do need to know that homeschooling is legal in all 50 states, but every state has a different requirement. There are some states that are very much hands-off and you hardly need to do anything, maybe check in with your school district when you start homeschooling. Then there are some states like the one I live in that is one of the highest regulated states for homeschooling. Even though there's a lot of regulation, once you get into it, you probably will realize it's just a lot of annoyance and a lot of paperwork, but it's not too bad. And you can homeschool fine, even in a state with a lot of regulation, even though it might not be ideal. So that's legal readiness. Now let's talk about teacher readiness, because I know a lot of you are wondering, can I really homeschool my kids without a teaching degree? Now, the professionals might tell you that you're not qualified. You hear this a lot. And as a former public school teacher, now homeschooling my 5 kids, I've been on either end of the equation. And I can tell you, parents are uniquely gifted to teach their kids. You know your kids the most. You have their best interest in mind. Who loves your kids more than you do? As a teacher, I loved my kids, but I mean, I had 30 kids every hour. The classes were switching in middle school. There's no way I could meet the needs of 120 kids that I saw every day. And honestly, while I love them as a teacher, I didn't love them as a parent. There is a big difference there. And as a caring parent, you are uniquely gifted. You are uniquely qualified to homeschool your kids. You do not need a teaching degree. It is a big obstacle in people's minds because they're used to the system that says in order to teach children, you need to have this professional degree. But what did I learn in university that I couldn't know as a parent? I mean, my teaching degree helped me manage kids in a classroom. It taught me my subject matter, sure. But as a parent who wants to learn alongside with your kids, you can learn what you need to know as you need to know it. My teaching degree taught me how to grade on a curve. You don't need to know these things when you're homeschooling. You're uniquely qualified because you're the parent, and you are going to use a one-on-one tutoring model, which is ideal. It's what every public school teacher wishes they could do. We wish we could get one-on-one with our kids and help them. And you get to do that every day as a homeschool parent. So that's the most effective teaching model anyway. Instead of teaching to a big group of people where you're teaching right down the middle, you're able to meet your kids one-on-one. You can learn as you go. You don't have to know everything when you start homeschooling. Don't worry about high school chemistry when you're teaching your first grader. You'll get it. You'll figure out how best to teach. Are you a high school graduate? If you've been through the system that is supposedly so wonderful, why aren't you qualified to teach your kids? I think this is a really important question, that when you're told you're not qualified, but yet you graduated from that same system, it just doesn't add up. You can't have it both ways. Either the system's great and you're qualified, or the system stinks and you're not qualified. But honestly, if you've been through public school, high school, and you've graduated, there is no reason you can't teach your elementary kids at least. What about high school then, you might say? You know, I didn't do great in high school. How am I going to homeschool high school? By the time you get there, your kids have hopefully learned to be independent learners. You can outsource. There are so many wonderful curriculums and online classes. You don't need to know how to teach high school chemistry. There are lots of options. You know your kids better than anyone else. Now, here's a little illustration that I hope will help. You know, when you become a parent, you grow with that baby. You learn as you go through the stages little by little. You don't know everything about parenting when you first get that newborn put in your arms. And in the same way, when you start homeschooling, you're going to grow into that role as a homeschool parent little by little, just like you grew into the role as a parent. The best time to start, if you can, is right away with kindergarten, because obviously you will grow with them. You can't really mess up kindergarten, right? As long as your kids are learning how to read, learning their numbers, I mean, you've been a success. and you'll grow with them. What do you do if you're starting with a teenager? It is still doable. It just might be trickier at first getting into a groove and getting into a routine. So if you're pulling your kids out of school, definitely do some de-schooling for a bit. This is where you relax everything. You learn with things like documentaries and a lot of reading and projects and field trips and fun things that are relaxed, play a lot of board games, read as a family, talk, be together. That would be de-schooling. And then after you've done that for a bit, you can start to pick up on the academics. And that's going to be a really good thing to do as well with teenagers when you're just starting out. Don't be rigid schedules right away, but start easing into it a little bit. So I hope this helped you realize that you really can homeschool your kids even without a teaching degree. You are qualified, and don't let the professionals tell you otherwise. So we have one video left. Is there only one right way to homeschool? And that'll be our next video, which I hope you'll check out. Don't forget to find all the information related to starting homeschool at 411more.com/new.